Hey folks, Brian Neunaber here. In this video, I'd like to show you the ILLUMINE Reverb's user interface. I think you'll find that it's quite straightforward. Let's first look at the knobs. Turning the top knob moves through the menu. If a submenu is available, a down arrow appears next to the top knob. Pressing the top knob enters the submenu, and pressing it again exits. If no submenu is available, pressing the top knob will jump to the preset screen. Turning the bottom knob changes the currently displayed item or parameter. In the top level menu, pressing the bottom knob enters the save screen. When a down arrow appears next to the bottom knob, pressing the bottom knob will invoke the displayed selection. Now let's navigate the top level menu. All of the most common adjustments can be made from this menu. Let's start at the preset screen. Once you select a preset, turning the top knob clockwise shows you the settings for this preset. The first is the effect. Then there are five main parameters. The first is mix, then three effect dependent parameters, in this case depth, tone tilt, and modulation width. And the last is level. On the next screen, you can select if you want this preset to be recalled by the foot switch. Then you have two setup menus, which we will cover in another video. You may have noticed a down arrow on a few screens, indicating submenus are available. Let's look at these now. On the preset screen, pressing the top knob enters the preset name editor. In this screen, turning the top knob selects the character. And the bottom knob changes it. Pressing the top knob exits this menu, and pressing the bottom knob goes to the save screen. On the effect screen, pressing the top knob enters the effect options menu. Here you have more parameters, and the available parameters depend on the effect selected. In this example, there's pre-delay, modulation rate, high pass filter, low pass filter, and high frequency damping. These parameters are different from the top level parameters in that only the five top level parameters may be assigned to the expression controller. As I mentioned previously, pressing the bottom knob enters the save screen. Here you can choose to save the preset, do nothing, compare your changes with the previously saved preset and revert if desired, or save your changes to a different user preset. Let's see what happens when I make a change to this preset. Now when I go to the preset screen, a not equal character is displayed before the preset name. This indicates that the preset's current state is different from what is saved. In other words, this is a reminder to save the preset if that is your intention. In this case, I'm going to revert the changes. Now let's take a look at the foot switch functions. There are two operational modes for the foot switches. In the first mode, the left foot switch functions as preset up, and the right foot switch as engage. In the alternate mode, the left foot switch still functions as preset up, but short pressing the right foot switch will preset down and long pressing will engage. In both modes, long pressing the left foot switch toggles the AB switch, which we'll cover in another video. When using a foot switch to recall a preset, the preset name will be displayed in double high characters for easier viewing from standing position. There are three modes for recalling presets: instantaneous, delayed, and queued. In instantaneous mode, presets are instantly recalled. In delayed mode, presets are recalled 1 second after the last change. This allows you to scroll through several presets, and only after you stop will the new preset load. In queued mode, which is what we have here, the display blinks to indicate that a preset is queued up. Then, long pressing a foot switch or pressing either knob will load the queued preset. So in this video, I gave you an overview of the ILLUMINE Reverb's user interface. I think it's fairly intuitive and easy, but what do you think? Let me know in the comments.